So what we're going to do today is we're going to look at how do you create a user persona, right? As a design objective, it is important to keep in mind a user persona. So how is it different? We usually look at needs and wants, hai na? When we are designing something, hum log requirements dekhte hai, right? A client gives us requirement, right? And we jump. Even when you were making the wallet, if you think about it, we could have just written down our objectives, usko kya chahiye, and start making the wallet accordingly, right? Why did we actually also find out what kind of a person he or she was, and also find out what insights you have? Why was it the second column was actually very important, right? Finding out what kind of a person your customer is, apart from just the requirement. It is because it allows you to create solutions that are more customized, right? Solutions that are a better fit. It seems tiny, you know, adding things like writing Aditya on the wallet when you're giving it. It's a very personalized thing, you know, or maybe finding out that somebody likes or doesn't like animals, you know. So those are very tiny, it appears to be very trivial objects, right? But it gives you a better insight on your customer, you know, even maybe come up with solutions that the customer hasn't thought of. If you deliver exactly what the customer needs, where is the innovation? Right? It gives you more insight. It helps you understand the person. So most projects out there, most companies in the world, they only act according to requirement. Wahi bolta hai na, hum log customer requirement kya hai, customer requirement kya hai. Nobody talks about customer kaun hai. Customer ko kya chahiye, right? Customer kaisi company, customer kaun, like what kind of a person is he or she, what are his or her hobbies. Hai na? It allows you to innovate with your solutions and develop solutions that are more customized, right? A quick example, not a very, it's appropriate, but it's not a very practical example, but it's still an example. So think about this. If there's a village and you find that there's a school there and the dropout rate of the school is really high, Hannah, nobody's interested in actually studying there, right? You actually talk to a person. Maybe his name is Ramesh, and you ask him, why don't you want to study, school kyun nahi aata, and he's like, I don't like it, I teacher log maarte hain, mujhe kuch samajh mein nahi aata, mujhe padhai nahi karna. And you would be like, toh kaisa school chahiye, they're like, must school chahiye, jahan pe padhai wadhai na ho and all that, right? Sometimes you don't even get a requirement from the customer, but if you found out from Ramesh, ki Ramesh tu bata ki tu kya karta hai, tu school nahi jata, koi baat nahi, tu karta kya hai? Like, time pass karta hun, doston ke saath rehta hun. So tera hobby kya hai, tereko kya pasand hai, chal school nahi pasand hai, usko hata, to pasand kya hai tereko? And he's saying, mereko football khelna pasand hai, right? You're solving an education problem. Football, it doesn't really have anything to do directly with education, hai na? So football khelna pasand hai. How does it have to do anything with it? And then you're like, tere dost log, you find out from him ki haan, he plays football with his friends and none of them come to school. They don't like it. Un logo khelna pasand hai bas, aur kuch nahi, hai na? What if you tweaked your school ka solution a little bit to say that, Ramesh, agar tu aur tere dost log aata hai school, we will provide you free football coaching, and maybe you'll have a shot at playing for the Indian football team. How about we rope in the Indian football team and we run a campaign in your village and all the surrounding villages that will scout for talent, right? And we spend 60% of our time studying, but mandatorily 40% of our time actually on football out there in the field, because it is something that the youth of this village is really interested in. And use football to rope in students back into school. You tell them that you need to maintain a minimum of 30% attendance in school and at least score 35 in your subjects, and then you're eligible for your team. You use something else to drive education. You would not have that information if you didn't find out what his hobbies were. So it allows you to come up with solutions that are fit for that customer category. Gives you insights, which is why requirement bhi lene ka, at the same time also study the customer, make a persona, and usko bhi requirement hisab se treat karne ka. So your character persona is actually going to be about your customer. Please write this. Your character persona is only for your customer. You're not going to put some other stakeholder there. It is going to directly be the customer to whom you sell, right? So Lohit, he realized that his customer is actually, he has to really reach out to the mother, you know, of the working Bombay guy, and not the Bombay guy itself, you know, because that is a customer. The money is going to come from his son, probably, or the husband, but your real customer, the decision maker, is the mother, right? So identify your customer properly, and then you make a customer persona, right? What is it? Why are we making a customer persona? We need to really make a real person out of it. All of us, when we are thinking in our heads, we are thinking customer, na? Are wo labor log? Are wo farmer log? Are wo garib log? That's how we think, na? We don't think of them as a real person sitting in this classroom. What would he look like? What would he wear? What would his likes and dislikes be? And a kaisa type ka insaan hota wo? Uska naam kya hota? Right? We treat customers as abstract people who exist on paper ya apne dimag mein. Haan, koi to customer hai. Haan, wo customer hai na, un logo ko bech denge. Kaun hai wo? It has to be a real person. So build a character persona, right? So how are you going to do it? Every team builds two character personas. Do asli insaan, right? Un logo ko naam do. Give them a name. Give them an age, right? What is their occupation? What do? Where do they stay? Write down 10 daily behavior traits. Daily, what are 10 things that according to you they do daily? You will have the question ki right now, sir, we don't know. Hai na, hum log ko pata nahi hai, sir, hum log thodi na interview liye hai un log ka. Because once you take a customer interview, actually it helps you make customer avatars or character personas better. But right now, give it a shot. Give it a shot because you'll learn that making a character persona actually is way different from imagining it in your head as an abstract parameter for your project. Right? So give it a shot. Write down 10 daily behavior traits. Wo log, aapke hisab se kya karte hai wo log 10 cheez daily? Hai na, kuch to karte honge apna life mein. They're not just suffering from the problem. What are the 10 things they do? What are their hobbies? What do they like? What do they dislike? What's their social life like? Do they like playing cards or do they like playing watching FIFA? What do they do? Sab likho. Make two real people and make sure that you mention wahan pe ki how do they solve the problem right now. They must be doing something about the problem, hai na? Kuch to kar rahe honge, right? Kuch bhi, whatever that is, suffering, doing something about it, finding an ingenious solution. So please write that down. How do they solve the problem right now? You're going to map user journeys. Theek hai? Now what is a user journey? Basically, you have people in that system. Wo problem already exists karta hai, sabko ye belief hai. Jo bhi problem you're trying to solve, you are not creating it. It already exists. If it already exists in the system, it means your stakeholders, your customers are doing something about it. Either bearing it, you know, they're solving it somehow in a not effective solution. Everybody believes that. So basically, your user mapping, user journey mapping mein do part hota hai. First part is you map what is currently happening. Current scenario map karna hai. Theek hai? And you map it using drawing. You have to draw it out. Draw the entire journey. What is happening right now? You have stakeholders. Sabke paas stakeholders hai. Sabke paas cause effect hai. Sabke paas verticals hai. So you know all the players in the system. You know what are the infrastructures in the system. You know everything right now. Theek hai? Make a map. What is happening? If you're talking about farmers, what happens? Draw farmers. They get something from the market. Who do they give it to? Draw that. Every single entity involved in your system, put it on paper. Draw your current system. Theek hai? And then, once you've completed drawing your current system, you're going to then draw what are you proposing. Theek hai? What is it that you are proposing and how does that fit into the system? Please draw every single entity separately. It's like a flow diagram, but it's more than that. Because you're mapping all the important stakeholders that you want to reach out to. So first, you will not map your solution. First, you're just going to map the problem. In the form of a drawing, draw it. Draw your stakeholders, draw your entities, kya chal raha hai, flow kya hai, kahan se saman kahan ja raha hai, fir kiske paas ja raha hai, fir kya ho raha hai. I'll give you a few examples of what it looks like to give you a better idea. Sad farmers likhke rakha hai, and fir bottom right corner mein happy farmers likhke rakha hai. Actually, un logon ne kaise divide kiya na, left side mein current system ko dala hai. Fir they found a way of how you can map that with your solution, because you have to understand that your solution is not going to be independent of everything. Hai na? It is going to be a part of a system. As in a vacuum, mein chalega, wo, ke farmers aayenge kahin pe kuch ek karenge and they'll go back and they'll be happy. That's not the case, right? It is going to be a part of an existing system. So you have to see how your product fits into that system. Try and put it on paper first. So that's an example. So you see, they have sad farmers and they have counties. See, their vegetables are being wasted. Waste ho raha hai, toh waste matlab kya? Where does that waste go? So see, they give it to animals. You know, either give it to animals or just dump it. Unhone wahan pe bana ke rakha hai. Fir they said ki, what if you could do a workshop or train farmers on give them awareness on storage and stuff like that and make a system which assists in budgeting and assists in planning, right? for and give them a little bit of funding. Using that, you can get bumper harvest, and usse you're going to have happy farmers who also have storage options, because they receive funding, they receive some literacy on how they can build facilities to store. You help them with all of that, and then you have storage options there. So this is just an example of what a user journey or a map looks like. So this is actually more of a solution map. But you guys, this is just an example. You don't have to imitate this, because you are first going to make a map of the user journey in the current system. Kya ho raha hai? Right? Uska user journey actually wahi pe khatam ho gaya. Sad farmers, because crops are being wasted, animals ko de de rahe, and that's why they're sad. Right? And a very important thing to notice here is that these guys paid attention to the fact that farmers are sad and farmers are happy. They're taking emotions into consideration, which is very important. Right? Anywhere in the system, if you find a place where farmers are already sad, and then they're having to deal with middlemen, and they're therefore getting less profit, it means that they're also angry. They're frustrated. It's an emotion that you would want to capture on paper as well. It's important to know where farmers are what. Right? Emotions are also necessary. Make a map showing relations between existing entities in the system, and then try and put your product, your service, your solution into that existing system and try and draw relations. How is it going to fit in? How does that look? A metaphor is when, usually when you give an analogy, we bolte hai usko, when you give another example which is like something that you're trying to describe. Why is metaphors and metaphor thinking important? A very good example is what happened earlier in the session during the interview, because we figured that सामान बेचने के लिए एक्चुअली मम्मी से बात करना है, नॉट विद द वर्किंग पर्सन, राइट? कंसिडर दिस, ऑल ऑफ यू हैव मेड टेक्निकल प्रोजेक्ट्स, ऑल ऑफ यू, राइट? इफ यू हैड टू गो होम टुडे एंड एक्सप्लेन योर प्रोजेक्ट टू योर मॉम, हाउ वुड यू डू इट? वुड यू रियली यूज द सेम वर्ड्स दैट यू यूज? यू वुडंट, राइट? बिकॉज इट वुड मेक नो सेंस, है ना? You would have to use a metaphor. You would have to use an analogy. You want to still explain, na? Life mein kuch kar rahe ho, right? You want to still explain it. Think about it. When you actually talk to farmers, tum kaise samjhaoge that you're setting up a system for information aggregation and delivery? Kya samajh mein aayega usko usse? Kya fayda hai? The person does not understand how computers work. Has not probably even touched a computer in his life. Usko kaise samajh mein aayega how is the system beneficial? You have to come up with a metaphor. Right, you have to learn how to represent your project, your solution in different ways, which is why we do metaphor thinking. Aya, does everybody understand why this is necessary? Does everybody believe that this is also important? Right, a lot of us, when we are doing research, when we are doing a PhD, we work on very complicated projects, right? But you have to understand that all of these projects someday will be applied into the real world with stakeholders who do not understand your research subject, who have probably never heard of it. But it is going to help them. And for it to help them, they have to understand and accept it. You know, they may not understand what natural language processing is, but if you could explain it to them in a language that they understand, and they see ki ha, agar aisa ho raha hai, matlab ye to kuch achha cheez hai mere liye, hum isko ek mauka zarur denge. Your work is done, right? So you have to learn how to think in metaphors, represent your project through something else. So what you're going to do now is, you know what your how might we statement is always primary. That is what we are working on. Everything is on the basis of that. Please don't try and justify everything. Abhi tum jo user map bana rahe ho, basically tumhara jo solution hai, your how might we statement ko hi represent kar rahe ho tum, right? Tumhara ek how might we statement hai, wahan pe ek primary stakeholder hai jiske liye tum actually solve kar rahe ho, who's your customer. To customer centric banate ho tum usko, and also baki stakeholders kya kar rahe hai wo system mein, wo bhi dikhate ho. But you're solving for your customer. Wo customer kaun hai जिसके बारे में तुमने अपना हाउ माइट वी स्टेटमेंट में लिखा है? यू आर सॉल्विंग ओनली फॉर दैट कस्टमर, नॉट फॉर अदर स्टेक होल्डर्स, इवन इफ दे मे बी सफरिंग, यू आर नॉट सॉल्विंग फॉर देम, यू आर ओनली सॉल्विंग फॉर दैट वन कस्टमर. क्लियर सबको? राइट? नाउ मेटाफर थिंकिंग में यू आर गोइंग टू टेक दिस टाइम एंड कम अप विद अ मेटाफर टू रिप्रेजेंट योर प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट, ठीक है? एंड हिंट टुवर्ड्स व्हाट द सॉल्यूशन इज. द मेटाफर इज फॉर योर प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट, नॉट फॉर योर सॉल्यूशन. Does everybody get that? So if you're talking about water being polluted and how that is affecting health, stuff like that, you will not come up with a metaphor right now for your solution. You will first come up with a metaphor for your problem, and then you will hint the solution in the end, again through a metaphor. So the metaphor first has to be primarily of the problem, बिकॉज उसके लिए भी मेटाफर चाहिए. लॉट ऑफ पीपल डोंट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट द प्रॉब्लम इज, क्यों ऐसा हो रहा है. मेटाफर थिंकिंग ऑल्सो हेल्प्स यू डिजाइन मार्केटिंग कैंपेन्स बाय द वे, राइट? बिकॉज यू वॉन्ट टू रीच आउट, यू वॉन्ट टू रीच आउट टू पीपल, यू वॉन्ट देम टू रियली अंडरस्टैंड. सो कम अप विद गुड मेटाफर्स, ठीक है? यू कैन रैप अबाउट इट, यू कैन मेक अ स्किट अबाउट इट, यू कैन मे बी डू अ डांस अबाउट इट, यू कैन सिंग अबाउट इट. जो करना है करो, स्किट करना है जो करना है करो, ठीक है? देयर इज ओनली वन रूल, दैट यू विल नॉट टॉक अबाउट योर प्रॉब्लम डायरेक्टली, रिप्रेजेंट इट थ्रू समथिंग एल्स.